Hey, they are one of the biggest music acts in the world right now, and the Stafford Brothers are a real Aussie success story. The Gold Coast Brothers are a DJ duo and basically get paid to party. Matt and Chris are back in the country. They join us now.
Hey, mate, how are you?
You guys are absolutely killing it. You've just come straight from the airport, a little bit jet lagged.
I don't really know what I was doing, to be honest. I was like, so straight off the plane, we just flew from Vegas.
Your name is Matt and you're in Australia. Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Because you guys have got a residency now in Vegas.
Yes, yeah. We've been working with the Light Group, with the Cirque du Soleil. So performing, there'll be Cirque du Soleil aerialists going the whole time. It's pretty special. And we were there for a good friend's birthday. It was on Monday and then we
straight here.
Wow.
Into this.
And we know that, like, DJing, everyone wants to be a DJ, bloody Paris Hilton wants to be a DJ. Basically, spoiled rich kids who can't do anything else want to be DJs because it is the best job ever. You basically just get paid to go to all the coolest parties.
Pretty much.
How do you get into it? How do you start?
Well, we lied to sort of get into our first game.
I like your style.
So that worked. We weren't these, like, sports celebrity sort of people, so we sort of got in there by just saying we'd done it plenty of times before. Right. Just filled up the club with all our mates and it went from there.
Yeah, I mean, we come from a musical background. Yeah. Like, we play instruments, we do produce music, so while we did tell a bit of a story, there was something behind it. So.
Because some critics of DJ say, I mean, how hard could it be? You press the play button and just stand there jumping around like a goose for
a
couple of hours.
It is easier.
What is the skill? What is it that really good DJs do that middle-of-the-road DJs can't do?
I think being able to read the crowd and seeing, you know, being able to work a crowd. We also originally used to play on vinyl, and that actually took skill. Yeah. It is getting a lot easier with the pushing the button type.
Because you used to have to sync the outgoing beat of one record with the incoming beat of another, and you'd have to time it and move it so that they...
Yeah, you've done this before.
Look at you. DJ, you're the best in the house.
We're in trouble.
I do a kind of, you know, DJ dancing, jujitsu kind of fusion.
I like it.
But they now have the electronic records that are actually... How does it actually work now with all the new technology?
Well, we actually just use an SD card now. So you can actually walk into a club, SD card and some headphones and that's it.
You are doing the same thing. So, you are syncing the two, but you're not controlling like a piece of vinyl as it used to be. It's now a digital... Sounds.
Wow!
So,
I just don't understand any of that. I feel so old and uncool.
You guys actually had your own reality TV show as well. You were commissioned by Real Madrid to reproduce their club anthem. That must have just been absolutely crazy, considering. And you know, back in the day, you guys used to DJ at my local nightclub.
Once or twice. Yeah.
I would stumble up to the DJ box. Hey, boys, do you reckon you could play
some Bon Jovi? Got some Bon Jovi on.
Got any chisel?
But what a ride. You must be just pinching yourselves.
Yeah, it's pretty good.
It is amazing, and especially like being in America now. It's, you know, we've been there for about 2.5 years, and it is, I mean, it's great to come back here as well, but like the clubs there are pretty insane.
Yeah, it's the next level. I mean, coming home for summer is great. We're doing a big tour this summer here in Australia, so it is good to be home, see friends and family. But yeah, we've been full time in America.
What does it take to cut it in the States? How do you break into it? There's obviously so many established players.
The big thing for us was we did a record deal with the label Cash Money. We had Lil Wayne and Christina Milian. That was on our single. Our last single was with T.I. and that. So the big American artists. We are dropping a new single in January and it's with a really good Australian artist, which we're really excited about.
It's not Frank Stafford, your cousin.
It's not Frank Stafford.
Can I ask about working with Lil Wayne? Yep. When you're on professional terms with Lil Wayne, do you call him Wayne or Lil? Or is it the full Lil Wayne?
I think it's Mr. Wayne.
I was using Lil Wayne.
And you guys at your home for Christmas?
I actually call him Toonchi. That's Toonchi.
Toonchi,
yeah. There you go.
Really? To his face?
Yeah, that's what he gets called. So then you're on the inside. Then you're on the Toonchi.
That's right, you're on the inside. You're home for Christmas. What are you looking forward to catching up on?
Family and friends.
Just, mum's cooking. Trisha Dish. We go there like every Tuesday. So, like at Christmas Day, everyone comes around to our house. It's an amazing day.
Oh, good on you guys. You're playing a whole bunch of gigs. All of the details will be on our website. Nice to have you home. Stafford Brothers, everyone.
Say hello to
Stafford. What's up, Toonchi?